Very cute.
Gay boys and girls and fan gangs and straight boys who sneak and watch my videos and love me too. Yes, I know you bitches be watching these videos. You all don't know how excited I am to have one of my personal favorite bloggers, favorite black people, favorite black gay people on this show today. Oh my Lord Jesus Christ, y'all don't understand. I feel like a Pentecostal pastor receiving money from the old ladies. We have Mr. Darian Aaron right here. You all know him from LOL Darian. Because you know I say Law Darian, I say. Yeah. What is the right way? Correct me now.
LOLDarian.com, Living Out Loud with Darian.
It stands for Living Out Loud with Darian because when I first ran across it about 4 years ago, you already know, like me being a comedian, I thought it meant laugh out loud. So
well, that's what it really means. But of course, I had to put my own little spin on it.
And I like this bit. I love this bit. This bit is fabulous. So first of all, thank you for everything that you do. Thank you for the news that you give us, because a lot of us would not have a place to go to get some of that news. And also, thank you for this project that we're about to present to you all today. For those of you all who don't know about it, haven't yet found out about it, this project that he has done today is just too big. Okay? It's just fabulous. He has done a book called When Love Takes Over, and we are in a bathroom, okay? And so we got this toilet tissue, and being a child from the South, I was always taught to be resourceful, okay? So these are coming with me, and we put this up here, When Love Takes Over, a celebration of same-gender-loving couples of color. It's a wonderful book. I got my copy tonight. We're here at the book release event. Tell us a little bit about the book.
Well, first of all, thank you for having me on your show, Sam. In the bathroom.
I know. It's hot here, too. I know we are in New York City. It is. I'm glad nobody came in here, you know. Okay. Tell us about the book.
When Love Takes Over, a celebration of SGL couples of color, is a coffee table book and exclusively profiles 18 same-gender-looking couples of color who are in long-term committed relationships.
Okay, and so what inspired you to do the book?
Well, what really inspired me was a lack of images of black gay men in successful relationships in the media. So I just took it upon myself, since I had a platform, to actually show those images because they weren't out there for public consumption. And I was really frustrated about the lack of positive portrayals of black same-gender-loving people.
Exactly, because I know, like, a lot of times when we look at TV, and although we love scandal, it's like black people, we always take things and we go make movies and CDs like about the download and the shit is wonderful. Like that's what made Soul Food and all them other boys Soul Food. Nobody was that. No, they had the gay boy in there. He was like, oh. That was not the download. It's just, you know, the download movies and stuff like that. It makes things more sensational, but it doesn't necessarily show us in a more positive light. I know I have friends who, female black friends, who saw Noah's Ark for the first time, and they were like, that was the first time that they saw two guys kiss.
Wow.
So it was a portrayal of it in film, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
So these are like real couples. How did you go about finding the couples?
That's a really good question. Actually, it wasn't very hard at all. Initially, I thought it would be. A lot of the couples emailed me once I started the Coupled Up series on my blog, and they saw how positive the portrayals of the couples were. And they wanted to be involved. So they emailed me, they Facebooked me, they sent me tweets, and we just kind of went from there.
And these are openly gay black male couples.
Yes.
These are couples who are not in the closet. They didn't meet in jail in some download relationship. They didn't.
Nope.
Because people go to jail and I don't even know what that is if you're in jail and that's not a relationship. That's something totally different. These are real black gay couples. And they exist all across the United States.
All across the United States and beyond.
They're in our schools, they're teachers, mm-hmm. they're in our hospitals, they're doctors, they're in our courtrooms, they're lawyers, they're pastors.
Definitely.
Many of which people are any pastors, any people who work in public service, are they in the book?
Not that I can think of, but a lot of the couples that are in the book are very spiritual. They invite God into their relationship, and they cite God as a reason why they've been able to stay together for as long as they have, actually.
Wow. Okay, so I was telling Darian, I was telling him that I have a problem, and y'all know why. Okay, with checking emails, I do demand the password to the phone.
Mm-mm.
I will put some arsenic in your spaghetti.
Mm-mm.
If you don't tell me who that bitch is that keeps coming down here bringing cookies when I'm at work slaving my titties for white folks over a coffin maker.
Hey, Blaine, calm down.
Okay.
You is kind.
Yes.
You is smart.
Yes.
You is important.
Well, you fix this. You're so wonderful. Oh, my Lord. You just touched my toilet paper titties so much. Oh, my Lord. Oh, it's so
now, you know you're doing too much with all that snooping around and checking emails and voicemails and acting all crazy.
I know. And you know something? I have kind of had a bit of an epiphany while I was out there looking at the book. I was looking at the book and I was like, this is something realistic because a lot of people really do give up hope.
Mm-hmm.
How do you think it inspires people who've lost hope for being in a successful relationship?
Well, judging on the feedback that I've received from people who have read the book and were familiar with the Coupled Up series, I get emails all the time that say, you've given us hope. I was one of those people who didn't believe that it was possible for me. But after seeing the examples of so many couples who have been together for as long as 20 years and they're making it work, they told me that they now know that it's possible for them too. And whereas before they were hopeless, now they're filled with hope.
That is absolutely amazing. So, and also earlier tonight we talked about the three keys to a successful relationship, which are?
Communication, trust, and was it honesty? DJ said
I had to respect.
Oh, respect.
You better respect me because I have a knife, okay? But I'm still working on some issues. We don't get there. How can people build their relationships with those three key elements of a successful relationship?
Well, they've got to have them, and they've got to constantly work on the communication aspect, the trust, and the respect, because without it, your relationship will fail. And it's an ongoing process. And when you have two individuals coming together to create one whole, you're going to have two different sets of ideals, and you're just going to have to sit down and actually communicate and work those problems out. So you've got to have those three key ingredients in order for a relationship to be successful. And it's hard. Being in a relationship is not easy. I've been with my partner a little over a year, and we're constantly learning new things about each other. It's hard work, but it's worth it.
That somebody just knocked on the door, so it's probably some lady who has to change her. I'm changing my pants! Okay. Before we go, what else do you have to tell us about When Love Takes Over? What is something that people should know about the book?
It was written for Black SGO men of color in mind, but it really speaks to anyone who has ever felt hopeless and you have a desire to be in a romantic, fulfilling, long-term relationship. It is possible for you, and there are 18 examples in that book that show you that it can be done. It can be yours if you want it.
So there are beautiful, long-term, successful, loving, and what other adjectives am I missing?
Healthy. I think it's important to be in a healthy relationship.
Healthy black gay relationship. Yes. They're out there. So it's not just the lesbians, because we covered that too.
Right.
Out there. You know, a lot of people think that lesbians are the only people who are open. That's another question I want to ask you. Why do you think it's easier for lesbians to be more open in relationships?
Well, I think society as a whole, they're more apt to embrace lesbianism more so than two gay men together, because immediately they get thoughts of what we do sexually. So, you know, we're more than what we do behind closed doors in our bedroom. I'm a whole person. I'm more than just what I do with my partner in our alone private time. So I think it's that fear, that homophobia that surrounds what two gay men do when they're alone. And we all know lesbians are every straight man's fantasy.
They
welcome that.
And I don't even have sex. I have a toy. Okay, so y'all need to mind y'all business unless you plan on finding me a man. Okay. Anyway, I do have hope now that I found one.
Well,
and
good.
When I come off the road, well, it's hard for me to do that, but I will work on trying to solidify a relationship. Anyway, I'm so glad that you joined me on this show and that you did this project, because it's something that people definitely need to see. And from what I understand, there's nothing else like it. So this is very groundbreaking. Didn't I tell you I'm changing my pants? This is very very groundbreaking, and I think it's wonderful, and thank you for what you do, thank you for what you have done, and thank you for what you're going to do.
Thank you, Sam.
Thank you for coming on. And so, you know, we need to get out of here, but this is wonderful, and this is the way I get a lot of my stuff. Y'all, thank y'all for watching, and y'all know when I visit places. What else do I need?
I hope your mother doesn't see this. Because I know she raised you.
I'm going to give you this, Mom. This is just for you. Okay. This is what you call a souvenir. Okay. Anyway, thank y'all so much for watching. Bye, babies. Mwah. Let's go.
Lord, have mercy.